necessarily always discriminatory, but it's just once you know how to identify yourself, you quickly start to identify others, and then you start, this perception kind of controls your decisions. This perception kind of controls, you know, in our industry, sometimes the gigs you get, and it's interesting. As for myself, I'm naturally a black actor, and I'm like the only black actor on my show, Chicago PD. And I noticed that sometimes I feel an ownership of certain topics, like if it's a black specific concept that we're dealing with on a certain episode, it's like, and it's not done right or respectfully, and with all due respect, all the writers on my show are white men, and that's cool. But sometimes I don't feel like they connect with the culture that I'm from, or they don't know how to write for the color of my skin. And so when I get like lines that I don't agree with, or if they don't deal with a certain topic the right way, sometimes I feel like it's up to me to own that. And I, as an artist, we get sensitive about stuff like that. But maybe you don't have to. You know, maybe.
You mentioned there was a moment where you first started realizing, mm-hmm, and judging, and like there was like something sort of turned on.
Yeah.
Where you realized your own race and your own, you know. Can you talk to me more about that, or anybody else? Like, what was that? Was there a moment in your life where you became aware of your own race and what that means and all of the?
I think, you know, just because of my upbringing, I was kind of always aware. You know, and I wasn't necessarily aware of discrepancies until, you know, you get to that age where you start to understand why, you know, this group of people kind of sits with this group, and then that group of people kind of look at that group weird. But, you know, as far as that's concerned, I guess within the arts, I think that's real. I think there's something interesting about that. I think it's a learning opportunity. I used to get offended, and that's what I was trying to tie it into. As the only black actor on the show, I can't get offended by a concept of my culture that isn't necessarily written in the way that I think is authentic. Only thing that I can truly do is lend my services in an explanation, or try to learn or educate the person that, even though, you know, they're a professional writer. You know, we're all here for education. I think we're all here to learn about each other. And so I think that I hindered that learning process by getting offended first and not taking that as an opportunity to teach that person, you know, a little bit more about what my culture means and how you can effectively produce for that genre of piece.
Yeah, I'd like to open that up to all the panelists, because one of the questions I asked in people when I interview, and you saw today with the older black male character that says, Emmett Till, that's when I realized that I was black for the first time when that happened. When was that first time for all of you? And how does that affect you as an artist as well, too?
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
I mean, I think in terms of what you were referencing, the notion of self-identifying, how we should become self-aware, I think understanding race is a construct that is imposed upon us. Understandably, I would say it's a privilege to not have to have been identified before I self-identified. I think that I lived in a part of Southside Chicago where it was all white. There, when I was birthed, I mean, if I was aware of that, I was aware that I was a black child before I knew I was a black child, because of how my family unit, and also because of how I was perceived. How I was perceived by neighborhood, by things that are imposed upon me. So, I think the notion of then moving to a place where I self-identified was I began to understand that it was beyond a dimension that was negative. It's beyond a dimension that was about something that was inferior. When it became a place for me to understand that it lived in a kind of deep spiritual place, and that came from a kind of, it had to be broken open, because I think that the notion when you actually self-identify, the kind of empowering notion of that, I think is a very challenging place for a lot of people when that is ultimately imposed upon them. And I think that when you speak about the notion of education, I think it's the moment where I feel like I didn't have to educate, because I feel like it was continually asked upon me before I even identified, I mean, before I even walked, before I was dealing with a little white boy when I was like 3 or 4 years old who was like smacking me because he was like, does it come off? I mean, I think that we have to recognize that that's 1970, that's not 19, you know, that's not 1901. So I think that the notion of it is that it's really for me coming to a place where I did not have to educate, where I did not feel like I could feel like I'd affirm, where I could say things that I feel like I did not have to further translate or reinterpret. It came from a place where I was like, yeah, I can hang out with this crew, and because we're all black and that's beautiful and that's good, and I don't have to feel like I have to look to someone else and say, well, now you know this is how I am, because that double consciousness, that constant notion of double consciousness, the ways in which we are constantly perceived before we actually come into our being, I think I'm still discovering that, but I think it becomes better as I grow and understand that I do not have to educate.
Yeah, that's a. I'm trying to remember. I think I was always aware. My parents are immigrants. They're from the West Indies, so I was very aware of, like, they were already different. So I think I was very aware of, like, okay, my parents are not from America. Great. I was born here, so, you know, it was melting worlds together. But my parents were very educated people, and they educated us to understand, I guess, where we come from, who we were, and what it all meant. And it was always in a positive way of like building. It was like we were sure in ourselves. So in that way, I hearing both of you, it was like a way where it kind of went hand in hand, the education and the being yourself of the thing. So it was like, if someone does say something strange, it's kind of like, you should probably rethink that and then come back to me. You know what I mean? Because you know what I mean? Let me tell you this, that's inappropriate or, you know, this and that. I was always very blunt and very to the point of something like, trying to think like an instance. I think I was in college and for the first time, I think my freshman year, because I went to a very diverse high school. I lived in New Jersey and there were people of all races. It was pretty, a huge melting pot. And I think when I was in college was a time where I think I was in a library or something and a friend of mine was laughing or doing something and someone turned around and was like, "Will you black bitches shut up?" or something. And I was kind of like, well, you know, my first reaction was like, yeah, wow, okay. So now I am, not that I was always aware of racism. I was always aware of people's prejudices and things like that. And it was like, okay, so this is it. This is the thing that I, not was, I don't think my parents ever sheltered me from it, but I just always was that person to be like, what you said was wrong, and you shouldn't have said it, and here's why. So, yeah, it's an interesting balance, I think, in terms of, like, where you sit in it, when you choose to do something, when you're kind of sit back and like, this person has to know they're ignorant, you know what I mean, and where, what you choose to do, and if you choose at all.
I'm Jamaican American. Stop that. So within the household, very similar to I can relate to a lot of those things, you know. So I was born in Chicago, but my first grade I moved to the suburbs of the city, out of the States, which is a totally different environment. So and also too, the environment that I lived in was surrounded by a lot of Indian. So, my upbringing, I never really had to deal with, like, I think while growing up, I was always labeled as the artist, as, like, the artistic kid, you know? I never really had problems with, I had a really good childhood. I'm very blessed. I had a really awesome childhood. Like, I got along with a lot of people, and I really used the time that I had to just develop myself, like creative, you know, explore the things that I was into, really try to just expand on my mission. And so with that being said, I think I never really had any like realizations until moving to Chicago for my education. 2009, I moved to the city to attend SAIC. And, you you know, like, at the same time, at school, it was just, once again, this development of learning myself and just trying to get more information on things I'm into. However, at the same time, you know, within the art world, there is this thing where, or maybe I should say in art school, when it comes to critique, critique is a process where all the students will put up their paintings or drawings or sculptures or whatever they're doing. And class as a whole will discuss about how the work is working, you know, in terms of content, in terms of normal forms of work. Now, SAIC has a very small percentage of black folks, it's only 4%. So, when it comes to the students, speaking about things about their identity, things about their history. Sometimes in those critical settings, it can be very, very strange. It's very hard to see eye to eye or be able to really address the situation appropriately. So those are some things that I've seen being at the school. There was also probably like a very major incident that happened with the police that also made me realize, okay, like there is a certain way that some people view me in society. It's like I have to be aware of that. So nowadays, like I'm more mindful. Of course, like Barack was saying, like when you know who you are, but at the same time, you also have to be aware of ignorance that lies that surrounds you. You know, so the biggest thing that's been blowing my mind, you know, being out of school and seeing society, is just the whole battle between individuality versus society. And, you know, I'm fascinated, I'm really into what Danielle's presenting with this play, because I think it deals with this kind of the struggle. And as I'm getting older and I'm seeing other people, I'm seeing my friends develop, I'm seeing family members develop, you can kind of see their own personal struggles with this thing. But it's also kind of making me realize how, once again, fortunate I was that I didn't have to grow up having to deal with these things. And I was educated. I was in an educational, I was like in an environment where I had the chance to do this.